Mo. So today I wanted to do a quick review of two BB creams, both by the same company. They are the Rimmel London BB creams. This first one here is the original 9-in-1 BB cream. It's the one that came out, I believe it came out last summer, of, 2013. It might have been around for a little while longer than that, but I was just getting into makeup then and I just found it, so I might be making that up. But this is in a small, squat little, for lack of a better word, shiny bottle. And the second is the Rimmel 9-in-1 Matte BB cream. This came out at the beginning of this 2014 spring season. So, and this is in a matte, taller matte tube. So as you can see here, this one is taller and skinnier, and this one is short and squat. They have different cap colors. I don't know if you're into that. My favorite color is purple, so I love this one, of course, for aesthetic reasons. Similarities, they both are a 9-in-1 skin perfecting BB cream. Both of mine are in the shade light, and they both are 1 fluid ounces. The 9-in-1 claims are: primes, moisturizes, minimizes pores, conceals, covers, smooths, mattifies, brightens, and helps protect, and it lasts all day. On this one, I think it says the same thing. Minimizes pores. Oh, maybe they're different. Minimizes pores, evens skin tone, mattifies, controls shine all day. Are those two the same? Smooths, soothes, conceals dark circles, helps prevent blemishes, and gives all-day coverage. So the 9-in-1 claims are completely different on both of these. I just read that. So, huh. That is interesting. Another difference is the original BB cream has a 25 SPF and the matte BB cream has a 15 SPF. Additionally, the lights between both of the, I guess, lines of BB cream, you would say, are different. This one leans a bit more dark and a bit more orange, and this one is truly something I would consider as light. The texture is also different. The original BB cream is more of a, I'll show you the caps too. I don't know if you can see this. It's more of a lotion, more of a thick, creamy foundation. It's not going to drip everywhere, and I wouldn't dare do that with the matte BB cream. I just dropped the cap. I would not dare turn the matte BB cream over like that. It is so liquidy. You can see, hopefully you can see, maybe I'll hold it up a little bit more, how drippy it is. It's just all over the cap and the inside of the cap too. I'm afraid it's going to drip out. It would. It reminds me of the consistency of the Garnier BB cream for oily skin that's like really, really runny, that you really have to stand upright like this. But the textures are different. This one is definitely like a runny, oh, hopefully you can see that drip. Oh, did I get that on camera? Oh, let's see if we can do it again. A little drippy and runny. If I had more, maybe you could see it. It's running down my hand there. Yeah. It's running down my hand there. And this one is, the original BB cream is definitely more of a lotion. And so it's coming out like a lotion. Hopefully you can see how creamy it is. I would really compare this to like a sunscreen, like a lotion sunscreen. Now, how am I going to do this? I can't really see the viewfinder. So this one is very smooth and liquidy. And this one is really creamy. Oh man, I hope you can see that. And you can see the difference in the color. Boy, do I hope you can. The, for lack of a better term, the original BB cream is more grayish to me, more of that true beige skin color. And the new one, the matte BB cream, is definitely a bit more orange to me. They both have pretty good coverage. I love using the original BB cream. I used it all last summer. It just has really great coverage to blend out. You can use a brush. You can use your hands. I like the ease of the application of the original BB cream. You can use your hands. It glides nicely. It's like putting on a lotion. But this one is more of a foundation. The new matte BB cream from Rimmel is more of a foundation. You definitely need a sponge or a brush. Let me just get this off my fingers here. You definitely need a sponge or a brush to distribute this on your face. It's not as easy to apply. It takes more time, if you will. So I'm not sure. I hope you can see how they're catching the light in the swatch. This is, for it being a matte BB cream, this one This one, the matte BB cream, is catching the light the most. It's very liquidy, whereas this one is a cream. It has more of a satin finish. I mean, I love both of them individually. If I want more of a foundation, I'm definitely going to go for the matte BB cream. If I want more of a BB cream lotion type, I'm going to go for the original one. I like them both for different reasons. This video is not which one I prefer over the other one. It's just definitely here are the differences between them. I definitely think that if you're into trying out BB creams and you want to find one you're going to be satisfied with, and you fall into the three colors, which are light, light, medium, and medium, then you should definitely check out the Rimmel line of BB creams. Rimmel has to be my favorite line from the drugstore. It's very affordable, and it's also really good quality. These two BB creams are amazing, and I believe they're under $7. They might even be around $5 each, or $5.50 or $5.60 or something like that. Definitely check them out if they have them at your Meijer, Target, or Walmart, because those are going to be the best prices. I hope you enjoyed this review. I hope you found it helpful. I hope it gave you some information you might have not known about the comparisons between the two BB creams, what they look like, why is one this, why is one that. If you did enjoy this video or found it helpful, as I'm swirling around my little cloth there, if you did enjoy this video or you found it helpful, give it a big old thumbs up and subscribe. You can also read more from me, as well as a full review and swatches of the matte BB cream, the Stay Matte foundation, and the Stay Matte primer on my blog. I'll link it below, but it is 516thsblog.com. You can also follow me on Twitter and Instagram. Both are at 516ths. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I will talk to you all later. Bye.